Hi everyone and welcome. I'm Clement from the Outpayce Checkout team and I'm really happy to be here today to walk you through integrating our checkout web component directly into your payment page. Before we dive in, if you're seeking a pre-built payment page, explore our Outpayce Checkout UI integration. In this tutorial, we will focus on the front-end integration, assuming you are familiar with generating a checkout session and have a valid payment page ID or PPID at your disposal. For a comprehensive understanding, we will cover basic functionalities here. For more detailed information, refer to the user guide. Let's get started. Also, I've chosen React for the demonstration. The process remains the same for any framework since our checkout SDK is framework agnostic. I've set up an empty application displaying a simple hello world sentence. Now, let's include the SDK file. Add the scripts and CSS to your web page, replacing with your preferred SDK version. For this walkthrough, we are using version 3.0.0. Next, replace the checksum with the corresponding one obtained from the manifest.json link. As a side note, if your website uses Angular material, there is an alternate CSS file available, lighter, without material rules, which you can opt for. If the checkout components are within a shadow DOM, insert the aforementioned CSS file into the corresponding shadow routes. Moving on, let's initialize the checkout components. Firstly, create a placeholder where the components will reside. For this demo, I will add some margin to it. Then proceed to initialize the SDK. Create a SDK configuration, passing it to the Amadeus checkout object. Set the container HTML ID and the payment page ID you've just generated. For the environment, set it to PDT, which is our test system, and use the English local. For now, let's start with an empty object for configuration, which we will fill later. To prevent the Amadeus checkout does not exist error, provide a hint acknowledging its existence as coming from an external script. The setup phase is now complete. Next, let's focus on implementing the callback handling. Callbacks are how the SDK communicates with your page. Several callbacks are available for you to use, so let's implement now the most important one. OnReady, triggered once the SDK is ready, providing a list of available payment methods. OnPayment method change, called upon change in components like the selected method or card bin. OnSuccess, fired upon successful payment, and OnError, activated when an error occurs. For each callback, I will add an alert for visualization purposes. Once all callbacks are implemented, don't forget to start the SDK by calling the .start method. Congratulations, your application now integrates the checkout web component. Well done. Now that the components are integrated, you might wonder, how can users make payments? You will need to add a pay button for that. Let's do that and style it for a better visibility. Note that the button might appear before the checkout component is shown. It is recommended to reveal the pay button only after the SDK is loaded. To achieve it, use a boolean set to true once the SDK is loaded. This is done on the onReady callback. Display the button only when the boolean is true. Now, let's initiate the payments when the pay button is clicked. Call the .pay method on the checkout object. To access the checkout object, let's make a reference on it and then use it. Upon clicking, if the input fields are empty, the SDK will display a validation error. Let's fill in a test card and proceed with the payment. As you can see, the payment is now successful. You've successfully integrated our web component into your payment page. Great job. Take some time now to explore the complete documentation and customize your page to create a wonderful experience for your clients. In the next episode, I'll demonstrate how to integrate our component without relying on any framework. Thank you for watching and see you next time.